Hey there, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily and I do mostly Salesforce tutorials, but I do sprinkle in some other related software tutorials as well from time to time. Today, we're going to be going over how to create a new custom report type within Salesforce. I do feel like I need to explain the difference between a report type and a report format. So report type is the different objects or the different groups of data that you choose at the very beginning when you are creating a report. Actually, let's go and we can look at the different report types that we have. I went to reports, go to new report. From here, we're choosing the report type. So this is what we can create a custom one of these, and that's what we're going to be going over. I'm going to click cancel. We'll come back to that later after we create the new report type. From here, we can go to the cog, go to setup. And this will take us to the back end of Salesforce. And I'm going to go to report types in the quick find. Double click, exit out of that. And this is just explaining what custom report types are. If you are familiar with inner joins and outer joins, this is essentially what you'll be creating, especially if you use multiple objects. You can also choose the different fields that you want to display in the report types, and this will dictate the different fields that you have access to report on later on when you're building out your report. I believe you can have different custom report types based off of the relationships that you have. So master detail and lookup relationships. I'm going to click continue and we can jump into creating a custom report type. All right, from here, we're going to select our primary object. I'm going to select accounts. The reason being, accounts is like the central hub for all other objects within Salesforce. Pretty much everything else relates back to accounts. I'm going to say accounts example, and then it will have the report name, will be the underscore, just the system name. Create a description. You do have to, if it has a red line, it has to have a description. So I'm going to just say it's account example report type for YouTube video. And this is a good point in the video to remind you to like and subscribe. You're going to store it in a category. This is perfect for the accounts and contacts. Then you're going to choose the deployment. So you can have this while you're developing it. You can choose if it's in development, so then you won't be able to access it, or if it's deployed. One thing is that, especially if you're working in a larger org, you want this to be in development, so then people don't have access when they are creating reports for their own personal use. But if you are working at night and you are at a smaller company, then you could just say deployed, and then you won't have to come and deploy it later. I'm going to say in development for now, so then I can show you how to deploy it later. Click next. Okay, so now we have our primary object. We can have this just be there, and then we can go in and select more fields possibly that we wanted to include later. I'm going to click relate to another object, and then let's go ahead and jump into another related object. So I want to add cases. This one would be really interesting. Why you'd possibly want to have accounts with cases is to be able to report on possibly retention rates for our customers. So let's say if they have 10 plus cases, it's more likely that they'll drop us as one of their suppliers or as one of their vendors. And then you can choose if this is related, an and or a with, as I like to call it. So you can have it where each A record must have at least one B record, or A records may or may not have related B records. So meaning, if you choose this top option, you'll show all accounts, and if any cases are showing, then it would be because they are related to the account. However, that can get a little sticky if people aren't so good about entering in their data and relating cases back to the account. However, there are ways to do that by creating a required case lookup field, or master detail is going to be required anyways. And then you can have where all A records show, but do not have to have any related B records. I'm going to click save. You do have the option of adding more data, but for the purposes of this, I just want to add that and just have it be simple. So from here, we can choose the different fields that we want to include. So these are the fields that are included. We can go to our accounts fields and see all of them are included. If we go to our cases fields, we could add account name, but that is already going to be showing because we have the account, and all the other fields are showing. Another thing is that we can relate fields from other objects here through a lookup relationship. So we could go to all these other objects that we didn't create on the initial relationship between accounts and cases. So possibly we wanted to understand who the accounts were created by. So their alias, and let me see, their full name. So then maybe we can see, like, possibly we have one or two service people who are not doing the best job at their job, and if that's what is causing a decrease in retention rates of our customers. From here, I'm going to click save. And that is essentially how you create a custom report type in Salesforce. I am going to put this into deployment. I clicked edit, deployed, save. And it'll take us back to that page. We can delete it or clone it. Now we have custom report type name is account example. So now I went back to my reports tab, and I'm going to click new report, and it should be able to get me to the accounts example. Here we go. Accounts example is our report type name. And now we are able to report on all these different things that we had selected in our custom report type. You can hit save and run. All right, that is how you create a custom report type within Salesforce. Thank you so much for joining me. This is a part of a bigger series I am doing here on my channel about reporting and dashboards, all that fun stuff. That'll be the first link in the description down below if you want to check that out. Like if you found this helpful, subscribe if you're feeling generous, and I will catch you guys in the next one.